Thar is a treatment heavy film. It was a very powerful story with very simplistic themes. The visual landscape of the film had a lot of potential.
It looked as if this village is for this film. It is a Western kind of a film based in Rajasthan. First day of my shoot, and when I reached there, I couldn't believe it, that this kind of village is there.
It looks like Texas, or it looks like Mexico, it looks like anything, but it is Rajasthan.
There's this road going into the mountains, and absolutely there's nobody there, and there's one lone tree. How do they find these locations? And in this film, it's been possible.
And even that fort, it's so perfect for what it's like been created, you know, but it's not. It's actually there and it exists, and the dust is real, and all of it is just real.
It's like a dream for a cinematographer. I hardly have electricity in the film. So the idea to be able to make something look cinematic and visual and appealing, but at the same time light it with fire, but not make it too dark, also expose their faces and make it visually exciting, was a great challenge for me.
I think we have tried to achieve such a world that has never been seen.
We kind of worked a lot in the tones and the color palettes of the film. How you kind of light in a way that it works and you make him look far more evil or angry.
Without this landscape, without this location, I think the film would have not been the same. So it's a very, very important part of the story. It helps in the storytelling.
I just have been very fascinated by characters that are outsiders, and they kind of, this urban mysterious guy shows up to like this deserted town, and then one thing leads to another. Initially, kind of when this person shows up, you're not really quite sure who he is, and I think it was very important to keep that mystery kind of alive. This character is somebody that's kind of not trying to fully reveal himself. I worked a lot on my voice. And I think in terms of the look, the clothes are very nondescript. They're very simplistic.
What this man is doing, unless you realize why he's doing what he's doing, it's very unnerving. It seems like a part of this country and this world, but is also very alien because it is very eerie.
I play this senior inspector. First time I'm playing Rajasthani cop.
You know, in the 80s, you had cops in Rajasthan. They were very nice, they were very rooted. Just one person could control an entire district.
पहली बार ऐसा लग रहा है कि हम चौकीदारी नहीं कर रहे हैं मंत्रियों की और अफसरों की असली पुलिस वाला काम कर रहे हैं.
There is this shootout scene with the horse involved and with the machine involved, and of course use a rifle and load it with those bullets. Was a lot of fun.
Satish sir's character playing Bhure, the camaraderie in rustic areas and rural areas, it goes back a long way. Like, you know somebody and they say, oh, we've been friends for 40 years. And in real life, they've been friends for 40 years. Then we have Chetna. She's living in a village. There's a lot of patriarchy thing, but she doesn't know better. So she's okay with all of that. But she's not a shy village woman. She's fiery. She would pick up an axe and get into a fight. But Mukti is more outgoing.
She's not intense, she's immense. She's so much that her energy just exuberates.
When we shot the character of Hanna with prosthetics, and when he came on set, everybody went like that. You know, it's all about these swollen eyes, bruised, cut lips, broken noses, just a lot of blood. It had to be brutal.
Kuwar, Hanna. All the characters are very well written.
As an audience, सोच में पड़ जाते हो कि ये क्या हो रहा है, किस लिए हो रहा है, इसकी वजह क्या है?
बता दी मुझे क्यों लगता है ये पिक्चर गब्बर के बारे में है? हो सकता है ये सब कुछ ठाकुर ने किया हो, और क्या पता शक्ति.
It's been a tough 45 days, scared.
It's a team film, Thar. It really, really is. Whether that was performance, whether that was lighting, whether that was blocking, direction. I think it's always really interesting to kind of take the audience on a journey without explaining too many things. I hope that it entices people into kind of get into that.